Hi everyone, welcome to this video. Now we at e-GMAT are starting with some really cool videos in which we would be discussing concepts of the most important chapters which are tested on the GMAT. Not only that, we'd also solve some really good questions after we are done with these concept videos. Now to never miss any of these updates, make sure you subscribe to the channel, and in that way you are always up to date with the latest content that we would be sharing with all of you. So let's get started. In this video, I'm going to talk about number properties, and I'll be taking the chapter of even and odd. So let's discuss the concepts of even and odd in number properties. Let's go with the basic properties of even numbers. Now, even numbers are those which are divisible by 2, right? So numbers which is 2, 4, 6, 8, that do not leave any remainder when divided by 2 are simply called even numbers. So the general representation or the standard form for all even numbers is 2a, where a is an integer. Now I'm just specifying that a is an integer. It can be a positive integer, it can be a negative integer as well, and we'll come to that. Now the difference between two even numbers is always even. Take any example, let's say 6 and 4. When you calculate the difference is equal to 2. Let's take another example, 22 minus 10, that's equal to 12. So essentially, the difference between two even numbers is always even in nature. Then, 0 is an even number. A lot of you might have this, that 0 is neither even nor odd, or a lot of people falter, and GMAT tests this a lot. So 0 is an even number, a very important thing that we have to keep in mind. Next, even numbers can be negative too. So if someone tells you that minus 2 is not an even number, that's absolutely incorrect. So minus 2, minus 4, minus 6, minus 12, you know, all these numbers, all negative numbers which are divisible by 2 are also even numbers. Now, that was all about the basic properties of even numbers. So now let's move ahead and look at the basic properties of odd numbers. Odd numbers are the ones which are not divisible by 2. So, for example, 1, 3, 5, 7, 19, 23, all these numbers are odd numbers. Now, since they're not divisible by 2, the standard form in which we write an odd number is 2a plus 1, where a is an integer. Again, a is just an integer. It can be a positive integer, it can be a negative integer, it can be a non-negative integer, for example, 0 as well. For example, I can write 1 as 2 times 0 plus 1. I can write 3 as 2 times 1 plus 1, and similarly I can write 7. So all numbers which can be written in the form of 2a plus 1, where a is an integer, are odd numbers. Now, the difference between two odd numbers are a very important thing, and a lot of students falter in. They think that the difference between two odd numbers can be odd as well. No, that's not the case. So let's take two examples. 5 minus 3, the difference is equal to 2. 21 minus 11, the difference is equal to 10. Take any numbers at your own end, you would see that the difference between two odd numbers is always even in nature. A very common faltering point that students often make when it comes to the GMAT is that they say that 1 is not the smallest, 1 is the smallest odd number. Now, basically this arrives from the fact that people think that odd numbers can only be positive. But odd numbers can be negative too. So minus 1, minus 3, minus 5, minus 7, all of these numbers are also odd in nature. So 1 is not the smallest odd number. Right? With that, so we had a basic idea about the basic properties of even and odd numbers. What happens when we apply some mathematical operations on these kind of numbers? And this is something that GMAT tests you on. So let's understand the effect of simple operations, for example, addition. Now, when you add two even numbers, the result is always even in nature. For example, when you add 4 plus 6, the result is equal to 10. When you add an even number with an odd number, the result is an odd number. For example, 4 plus 3 is equal to 7. When two odd numbers are added, the result is an even number. So 5 plus 11 is equal to 16. Now let's make a combination of that and let's see how does it affect. Essentially, even a combination of even and odd numbers would essentially take all the values or take all the properties that these three steps that I've written, these three pointers that I've written in the start actually follow. So let's take an example of odd plus even plus odd. Now when I add odd plus even, if you look at the second point I've written, even plus odd gives me an odd result. So odd plus even would be giving me an odd result. With that, if I add an odd number, look at point number 3, odd plus odd gives me an even number. So then the entire result of odd plus even plus odd gives me an even number. For example, 3 plus 4 plus 5, when you add 3 and 4, I get 7. And with that, if I add 5, I get 12, which is even in nature. What happens when I subtract even and odd numbers? Now, when an even number is subtracted from an even number, you know, the resultant is also an even number. For example, 14 minus 6 is equal to 8. What happens when I subtract an odd number from an even number? 4 minus 1 is equal to 1. I get an odd result. When I subtract two odd numbers, I get an even number. 15 minus 11 is equal to 4. And again, if you look at a combination, the properties would remain the same. So odd minus even minus odd. Let's first calculate odd minus even. It gives me an odd result. Minus an odd. So odd minus odd. Look at point number 3. It would give me an even result. Take an example for that. 13 minus 4 minus 5. 13 minus 4 is equal to 9, which is odd. Minus 5, which is again an odd number, gives me a resultant of 4, which is an even number. Let's take another look at the other operations that are there. So let's take a look at multiplication, for example. Now, when you multiply two even numbers together, you get an even number. So 4 times 6 is equal to 24. When you multiply an even number with an odd number, you also get an even number. But when you multiply two odd numbers together, the resultant is an odd number. Well, very important thing to note over here is when you multiply an even number with anything else, any other integer number, then the resultant is always an even number. And the combination of the same also holds the same properties. Very interesting. What happens when I divide even or even odd numbers? Now, when an even number is divided by an even number, you get multiple cases. For example, if you divide 4 with 6, it would be 1.5, which is not an integer. If you divide 4 by 2, you get an even number, which is equal to 2. And if you divide 6 by 2, you get an odd number, which is equal to 3. Similarly, the same happens when you divide an even number by an odd number. You get multiple cases. I've listed down the examples. The same also happens for odd numbers. When I divide an odd number with an odd number, I may get a non-integer or I might end up getting an odd number itself. But a very important thing that GMAT also tests us on is when you divide an odd number with an even number, the resultant is always a non-integer. So you can take an example and the resultant that you would be getting would always be a non-integer number at your end. With that, let's come to the part where GMAT tests us the most, that is the effect of exponents. What happens when I have even bases? Now, when I have an even base, if I raise that to an even positive integer, for example, 2 to the power 4, which is an even positive integer, then the resultant is an even number. When I raise an even number to the power of an odd positive integer, again, the resultant is an even number. However, there's one small thing that you have to keep in mind. When you take any even number apart from 0 and raise it to 0, which is again a non-negative even integer, it's equal to 1, which is odd in nature. Any even number raised to the power a negative integer can lead to multiple cases. For example, 2 to the power minus 1 leads to a non-integer, that is half. 0 to the power minus 1 gives you 0, which is even in nature. So these are the multiple cases that you have to keep in mind. Alright, now let's start off with the odd bases. Now, so what happens when I have an odd base? For example, let me take an example over here. An odd number raised to the power an even positive integer, for example, 3 raised to the power 4 gives me 81. So that is odd in nature. An odd number raised to the power an odd positive integer gives me an odd result as well. For example, 3 to the power 3 gives me 27. An odd number raised to the power 0, for example, 3 to the power 0, would also be odd. It would give me a resultant of 1. An odd number raised to the power a negative integer. Now, that can lead to multiple cases. For example, if 3 is raised to minus 1, then I'll get a non-integer, which is equal to 1 by 3. If minus 1 is raised to the power minus 1, the resultant would be an odd number because the resultant would be equal to minus 1. Now, based on all of this, GMAT tests us on three major important things. First, is any even number raised to the power, any positive integer is always even in nature. Any odd number raised to the power a non-negative integer is an odd number, and any integer other than 0 raised to the power 0 is equal to 1, which is odd in nature. So please do keep this in mind. All right. So now let's understand what are the important things that you need to learn to master GMAT number properties, essentially the even odd part. The first thing is simplify the even odd questions that you get based on the variable's even odd nature and not by taking numbers. So do not plug in numbers and check the resultant is an odd number or an even number. You know, that can lead you to missing cases and hence can increase the chances of errors. So for example, you know, the moment you see that in a question you have been asked the even odd property of 3 to the power k and it is mentioned in the question that k is a non-negative integer, it should strike your head that, you know, 3 to the power k would always be odd if k is a non-negative integer. 2 to the power k, if the question asks what is the even odd nature of 2 to the power k, then and in the question it's given that k is a non-negative integer, you should evaluate this and infer that, you know, 2 to the power k, if k is a non-negative integer, can be even and can also be odd because k can also take the value of 0. So these are the small inferences that you need to keep in your head and you need to make to ensure you solve questions in a much accurate manner. The second thing is consider all cases. You know, most of the students who falter at even odd questions falter because they fail to consider all cases. So this is a very important process skill. And to know more about this process skill, just YouTube, search on YouTube as e-GMAT process skills and you'd get a complete list of videos, you know, on how do you not miss to consider all cases. Right. So these are the two very important things that you need to keep in mind, keep in your mind to ensure that you do good in GMAT even and odd. Keep in mind that we will be posting questions based on even and odd to test your learning. So once you're done with this video, I hope your basics are right at your their places. So make sure you attempt those questions and do not miss the updates, do not miss the video updates that we would be posting. You know, subscribe to the channel so that you get a notification directly when we post the solution or the videos that are scheduled after this. Till the next time we meet, have a very good day ahead and happy learning.